Hello, good morning students. Now we will start our next point. See, already we have started a new lesson, that is carbon and its compound. So we have learned about the basic information of carbon, structure of carbon and its compounds. Okay, so now in carbon and its compound, some important points that you should know. So now we will discuss about the main points. Now see, as you know that diamond, everyone know diamond. Okay, see here picture is also shown, this is known as a diamond. And see, now graphite, you know, see in your pencil, okay, that pencil, what it is used, that is known as a graphite. Okay, see her picture, it is a shown. Okay, so this pencil and diamond, these are both a substance. Okay, both are the object. So what is the difference in between them? See, the diamond is very hard, okay, and graphite is soft. But the main thing it is, that is both the contain carbon, means this diamond and graphite, both are the example of purest form of carbon. Then why is the difference? Because diamond is very hard and graphite is soft, okay, but in both the different it is there. So that difference, see, means the chemical property is same, because both contain carbon, but physically they are different, means physical properties different, because it is very soft and diamond is very hard. So why this difference be found? So because the one important point, that is a allotropy, okay, because of this property we can see the difference in both these two substances. Chemical properties are same because both are the purest form of carbon, okay, but the physical properties are different. And why this so? The main important point, that is for allotropy, okay, because of this property they are having the different physical properties. Now see, what is a allotropy? Allotropy means what? See here, I have written the definition, that is allotropy is the property of some chemical elements to exist in two or more forms. So allotropy means what? It is the property of some chemical elements. Now elements, you know, so many elements, there are total 118 elements are present, okay. So allotropy means what exactly? It is the property of some chemical elements to exist in two or more form with identical chemical properties. Now with identical chemical properties means chemical properties same, okay, identical chemical property but different physical property. So now just now we have discussed about the example, that is diamond and graphite, okay, they are having a chemical property same because they both are the purest form of carbon. But what the physical property is different, because diamond is very hard and this graphite is very soft, okay. So these, the allotropes of carbon, these two are the one. Why it is known as the allotropes of carbon? Because they both are showing the identical chemical properties. Okay, why these two examples known as the allotropes of carbon? See, it's very important. This is extra, totally new point for you. So understand it properly. Okay, this video you at least you see two times, then you will understand better. Now see, these allotropes of carbon, for example diamond and graphite. So why these two, diamond and graphite, is known as the allotropes of carbon? Because they identical chemical properties, means what? They are having a same chemical properties, means they both contain carbon. But property means what that you know, okay? Shape is different, color is different, so structure is different. So they are having a different physical property, but chemical property is same. So these both are known as allotropes of carbon. Do you understand allotropes of carbon and what is a allotropy? See here, I have written the definition. Allotropy is the property of some chemical elements to exist in two or more same chemical properties but different physical properties. And these two allotropes of carbon, that is diamond and graphite. Now see, these are the allotropes of carbon, for example, diamond and graphite. There are main two types of allotropes. Okay, it means carbon is found in a different two types of allotropes. Now in allotropes also there are two types, so that now we will discuss. Now see, just now we have discussed about the allotropes of carbon. Okay, means examples we discussed, that is diamond and graphite, both are the examples of allotropes of carbon. But there are two different types in allotropes of carbon. So these two types are, the first type is crystalline allotropes. Okay, this is first is crystalline allotropes and second one is amorphous or non-crystalline allotropes. See, after this lecture you write whatever the points are written on a blackboard, okay, because it's very important for you. So these allotropes of carbon, now you have understand about allotropy means what? Means what the chemical properties same but different physical properties are known as a allotropy, okay? And these allotropes of carbon are further divided into two main types, that is the first type is crystalline allotropes and second type is amorphous or non-crystalline allotropes. Okay, now we will discuss first about the crystalline allotropes. Now crystalline allotropes means what? See, in crystalline materials particles are arranged in definite pattern. See, in crystalline materials particles are arranged in a definite pattern and as a resulting in definite geometrical shape. See, in a crystalline allotropes, the particles, now you know that any substance is made up of atoms, molecules, okay? So now we have to think about that way arrangement. The particles, atomic particles, means they are arranged in a definite pattern, a fixed pattern. And as a resulting, and because of these, they have a definite geometrical shape. Okay, means now that particles arrangement with your naked eyes, you can't see that particle arrangement. So for that we have to use a microscope and then you can see the arrangement in a particles. Okay, so for example, diamond and graphite, these both are the example of crystalline allotropes. Now you will say, madam, the diamond shape is different, graphite shape is different. Means okay, diamond, but the particles arrangement inside the bonding, okay, the structure is a fix. Okay, so because of these they have the crystalline, and because of these two are the example of crystalline allotropes. Okay, now see here in this picture, it is a structure of diamond. Okay, now see how the structure of a diamond, it is in a particular pattern. Okay, means how they bonded with each other, it is in a particular pattern. Means if you will take a one piece of diamond and if you will observe with microscope, then you can see the arrangement of particles in this way. Okay, because they are having in a particular pattern arrangement, particles arrangement, so they have a definite geometrical shape. Now see another picture, this is a graphite, okay, graphite particles arrangement. Now see how the graphites are arranged. the first layer, second layer, third. Okay, means they arrange in a sequence. So, and they flexible. So, because of that, the graphite powder, if you will take, that powder is a slippery because they are having this way arrangement in a particles. Okay, but they are having a definite pattern, and because of that they have a definite geometrical shape. So these two are examples in crystalline allotropes. Okay, see this point, it is given in ICAC book. So I will send you the photos of these notes also to you, okay? Because everyone is not having ICAC book, but those are having a ICAC textbook, you just read information, okay? Now see the second type we will discuss, that is the amorphous or non-crystalline allotrope. See, these amorphous or non-crystalline allotropes, these are totally opposite of a crystalline allotropes. Why? Because in crystalline allotropes, they are having a definite geometrical shape. Okay, their particles arrangement are in a pattern. But in amorphous allotropes, see, in amorphous material, particles do not have a definite arrangement. They do not have definite arrangement. Okay, and as a result, these materials not have a definite shape, and because of this they are not having a definite shape. Okay, so these two are the examples. See, coal and coke, these two are the examples of amorphous or non-crystalline allotropes. Do you understand it? See, once again, the amorphous material particles do not have a definite arrangement, and as a result these materials not have a definite shape. Now see, these are the physical properties are different because we have discussed in a allotropy. So allotropy means what? The physical properties different but identical in a chemical properties, means chemical properties are same. See, coal and coke, these both contain carbon, and this diamond and graphite also contain carbon. So chemical properties of these examples and these examples are same, but they are having a different physical properties. Okay, so after this lecture, just write down these all the points in your chemistry notebook, and I will send you some in the notes related to this topic, because this topic it is not there in your regular syllabus. Okay, so thank you.